everybody, how's it going? Fernando García here. Welcome to El Pío Online Stoppage Time, acompañado de El Super Mojado and Edwin Cáceres. But before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, El Pío Online, and to follow us on all of our social media platforms. And well, let's get started. So, Leagues Cup llegó a su fin con la final de Seattle Sounders y León, y terminó ganando León. Edwin, what do you think?
It was actually a really exciting game, man. I watched the whole game. It was, I think Seattle Sounders proved why they're one of the top teams in MLS. But the last two, the two mistakes, the PK and the mistake from the defender, this kind of what ruined their game. But at the end of the day, León finally won their first international tournament, and they deserve the win.
Yeah, definitely. I think the Seattle Sounders mistakes was what ended up costing the championship. But Super, any opinions on that game?
Well, listen, man, it was really exciting. You know, the game was so exciting that I fell asleep in the first half.
Es que lo bueno estuvo en el segundo tiempo, Super.
No, but I know it's like, it was a, you know, I guess a game, a tough game for both teams. You know, Seattle is one of the teams is one of the best teams in the MLS. In the past few years, you know, they've been dominating, in my opinion, esta liga, and not only in the field, but on las tribunas as well, because Seattle has a huge fan base, and I remember the first time I saw a game of Seattle, I was watching a European team, you know, because they were all chanting and with the scarves and all that, and I liked them. I was going to get those uniforms, their uniforms for one of my teams. But anyways, going back to the game, I think, yeah, until the 80th minute that they managed to, León managed to take the advantage. I'm telling you, man, I saw the highlights. What do you want to tell you? I fell asleep, but no, it good for León. Le costó, you know, just like le está costando a la Liga MX en selección and you know, teams like this to beat MLS, they're getting more and more competitive. And you were seeing it here, man. They took them 80 minutes to get finally the victory. And mira lo que ha pasado en el verano with la selección mexicana against US, man. It's just, I think... you know, in my opinion, I think it was a decent game for the people that watched the whole game.
Yeah, but then, you know, you get to the end and then you see those mistakes. Y son unos errores muy inocentes. And I think that's what separates the Liga MX with MLS. Because, you know, I don't think stuff like that would happen in La Liga MX. They're not as often.
Against Argentina. Come on.
I mean, everybody has an opinion. Anyway. So that was the end of that Leagues Cup, that whole format. And we're going to get a whole new format for 2023. If you guys want to take a look. So in this new format, the MLS and La Liga MX are going to have to pause the regular season so they can play, you know, each other in just one whole month. And it's going to be kind of like a World Cup style. And there's going to be three spots that are going to be given for the CONCACAF Champions League. And this tournament is officially sanctioned by the CONCACAF.
Well, only one spot is actually direct qualification for the round of 16. The two other spots are going to be going out. Are going to be two rounds of qualifications. They still have to play another extra two games to be able to see if they qualify to the round of 16. At the end of the day, this does not benefit Liga MX at all in their performance on the pitch. We already talked about this previous to this. Had a little conversation previous to this, where honestly, to me, just not this. I just don't care about it. It's another Copa MX. It's another MLS.
But Copa MX was successful. People liked watching Copa MX.
Come on, Fernando.
The only people is you, Fernando.
So you're telling me on the weekdays there's no soccer games.
I don't want
now that there's a Copa. That when there was a Copa MX, I would watch it because there was nothing else to watch, and I love soccer.
I'm sorry, sir. I got to think of life. and I work no. and I and you know I don't
listen.
That's the thing. That's one of the things that the Federación Mexicana wants. They want to have a soccer game for every day of the week, which is good. But then also you gotta give the audience some entertainment, man. I do not want to see San Luis against Nashville. I don't want to see Austin FC, which is the team that I kind of rooting for right now in MLS, which they suck.
But this happens in Europe too. In Europe, they have the Champions League, they have the European League. Then each league has their own little league between the second division.
Hey, look who you get in the group stage of the Champions League. Real Madrid against Inter de Milan.
But that's not all the. Sorry. That's not all the games. That's just one game out of
and
how
then,
many?
And then in the Euro and the European Cup,
Las Brujas de Bélgica le empataron al PSG, and that's stuff that you're gonna get to see in this little tournament. Tal vez Juárez ganándole al LAFC. Querétaro ganándole a Seattle Sounders. It's a good tournament. A ver, Super, what do you think about this tournament?
No, I think that it is una copa, tipo Copa MX, you know, something that these two leagues se inventaron, se sacaron de la chistera.
Es Copa MX versión fresa.
But you know what? I just want to give it like, you know, the benefit of the doubt. I want to see it. I like the format. You know, I like the World Cup like format because you're going to have groups.
You're going to have groups.
Va a haber elimination rounds and then you're going to have playoffs. It's going to be cool, man. I think that it's good for the smaller teams that don't get to participate on a regular basis in a Conca Champions.
We know who's going to end up in the round of 16.
In the World Cup, we know Argentina's going to make it. We know Germany's going to make it. But we still watch because we're interested
to watch the elite players in the world. I mean... Te vas a poner a ver la Conca Champions con lo que salió hace poco el vicepresidente de Surinami a los 61 años, todo panzón jugando. Is that exciting? Is that exciting to you? Is that soccer to you? Really?
That's a cool anecdote to tell. Like, that's funny.
That's funny. But no, but mira, that's not what I want to watch in this, soccer. I don't come to watch soccer for the comedy of it. I don't. I want to
But Fernando had a point because even in Champions League, man, you always have the same teams in the final round.
But you get to watch exciting so you get to watch the top players in the world.
No. There's some games from Champions League that are like 0-0 and you're like, this is boring. And they're supposed to be the best teams of Belgium, the best teams of Germany, the best team, and they still give you boring games.
Sorry, a Bayern Munich game will never be boring. They
beat. But that's one team. That's one team.
They beat 3-0 Barcelona. And they beat 8-0 Barcelona last time.
There's like 20 teams.
So you're telling me if you get to see PSG, you'd rather watch San Luis against Nashville than PSG against Manchester United in the round of 16.
But Edwin, you're thinking now just on a television basis, all right? I think that this is going to be cool for the fans in U.S. because now they get to, you know, bring all of the teams to aquí a los States. And listen, man, I mean, tú sabes que la fanaticada aquí is going to go to all the stadiums. You know, there's fans aquí. Hay suficientes pero, mexicanos sí, para...
Como quiera vienen. Ellos no. Vienen en el verano. La mayoría de los equipos...
Por eso, pero no vienen todos.
En este verano estuvo Querétaro, aquí en pero San Antonio, eso estuvo te, Pumas,
esos,
estuvo
en esos juegos
Pachuca,
no te ganas nada.
Estuvo América, estuvo Chivas.
Son juegos mal organizados, donde no te ganas nada. Este es un torneo bien organizado donde... Te estás jugando algo.
Cruz Azul, León.
Mira, te imaginas un Puebla aquí en Nueva York, man. They fill that freaking stadium. Todos los poblanos que están aquí en New York.
Las ratas del subway.
They will fill the stadium. I'm telling you, man. Believe me, va a ser una fiesta.
Yo los entiendo. yo los entiendo en la manera para traer dinero, para traer a los fans, para traer dinero hacia las dos entidades, hacia las dos federaciones. That's perfect. To me, I understand that perfect. I understand why MLS will want to do this because they want to get their structure into the youth academy a little better. Right now, the only academy that's legit that has provide legit players for the United States soccer team is the academy of the FC Dallas, which is one of the top academy level teams in the U.S. for all their or the youth academy teams. They always end up competing in a top level, but I don't see anything beneficial coming to Federación Mexicana but the money. That's all it is. That's all I'm scared of. That we're going to bring rules that right now, all of the Latin coaches, including myself, that I coach at a top level like at the Juventus Academy here in San Antonio, we are scared that all these rulings that they have, all these new rules for little kids that they have that do not let them touch the ball with their heads when they're freaking 12 years old because they're scared.
I don't think this tournament is going to be the gateway.
This is the beginning for the fusion of the Superliga Norteamericana de Naciones.
It is a test to see how it's gonna work out, how much attendance they're gonna get. I see it like that because all the talks about the fusion, but US and Canada they've been combined since the start, no? I mean,
and yeah, they both suck.
But listen, ahora que van a tener un mundial, all three countries. That's what they're trying to do. They're trying to create their own torneo like Sudamérica has. You know how Sudamérica has like Copa Libertadores. Yes, they have like Sudamericana.
We already have it. We have the Conca Champions. La Sudamericana y la Copa Libertadores incluye a todos los equipos de todos los países de su continente. Que eso se les quede bien claro.
But okay, aquí so están if you're talking about quality soccer, están excluyendo a
Honduras, están excluyendo a El Salvador, están excluyendo a Isla Guadalupe, a Belice, a Nicaragua, están excluyendo a todos esos, ya lo tenemos en una Champions.
You're complaining about the quality of the game between a Juárez against a Nashville, right? I guarantee you that game is going to be better than a game between a team from Guatemala against a team from Nicaragua. So if we're talking about quality of soccer, this one's going to be better. And that's what we're looking for, correct?
La Conca Champions, the new ruling of the Conca Champions, ustedes saben que los equipos ya califican directamente, los equipos de Estados Unidos y de México califican directamente al round of 16. ¿O no?
Pues sí.
Entonces... En mi televisión, en mis canales, no me enseñan un partido del Olimpia de Honduras contra Comunicaciones.
Pero ahora, yo no veo
esos partidos, al menos no sé si Fernando los vea, pero yo no los veo. Yo para mí, mira, te la voy a poner así. Para mí lo que debería estar enfocando en la Federación Mexicana es reforzar sus equipos bien, competir entre su misma liga, hacer una liga top, tener mejor infraestructura. ¿Cómo puede ser que el equipo del Sheriff de Moldovia calificó a la Champions League teniendo un estadio de 25,000 personas y en la Liga MX eso ni siquiera pasa los códigos de seguridad para poder tener un equipo en primera división? A ver, ¿cómo es posible que pase eso y nosotros queremos llamarnos una liga top, una liga élite? No puede ser esto, no puede pasar así. Tenemos 8 a 9 extranjeros en nuestro roster de jugadores por equipo. Y eso sin contar los naturalizados. A ver, no se le da oportunidad a los chavos. Sí, a lo mejor este torneo de ustedes me van a decir que se les va a dar oportunidad a los jóvenes para que se muestren, para que los de la sub-17, sub-20. ¿Cuántos chavos no se les dio esa oportunidad durante Copa MX que no estaban listos para hacer esa transición? ¿Y cuántos no quedaron perdidos en Liga de Expansión, en Liga MX, en Liga Premier abajo, en la Liga Premier Mexicana, que es una tercera división? ¿Cuántos jugadores no quedan como Espericueta que se van a jugar a una Liga de Balompié Mexicano, una Liga después de ahí? ¿Cuántos jugadores como tostado, no se les dio el seguimiento, y un campeón de un Mundial Sub-17 no se le da el seguimiento que se le tiene que dar, la proyección para llegar a jugar a la Liga MX. ¿Cuántos jugadores como este Omar Fernández, que está jugando el homónimo del jugador de León, pero que estuvo como compañero de JJ Macías, como compañero durante todo ese tiempo, durante todo el proceso en Chivas, y ahora es uno de los auxiliares del preparador físico del primer equipo de Chivas? Dime, ¿qué pasó ahí? Es que no podemos tener una liga top, no podemos tener una liga top y no podemos estar pensando en dinero cuando nuestra infraestructura es un asco, es una peste. Yo lo viví en Tigres en persona, y yo lo viví de primera mano. La infraestructura de Fuerzas Básicas de México es un asco. Los que mejor llevan y apoyan a los jugadores es el equipo de Pachuca, es el equipo de Atlas, que son los, y el equipo del América últimamente en estos años lo ha hecho muy bien. Pero dime, si un jugador no está listo, lo vas a echar a perder y se va a caer en el olvido. Así de simple. Ha pasado con muchas generaciones que han sido campeonas del mundo o han llegado a semifinales de equipo sub-20, de torneo sub-20 con selección mexicana. Gánenme esa.
No, güey, pero mira, es que ya terminaste de desahogar. Are you done like with all your... el rencor que te dejó la Liga MX? Is that what it is? Hold on. Is this segment called ¿cómo era? Stoppage Time o el rencor de Edwin? Listen, güey, ya te fuiste más allá. You're going way, te estás desviando, mi chavo, right? I mean, they're trying to create a tournament, como ya lo sabemos, para crear dinero, just to make money, all right? And if you can try this out before making this, in my opinion, it's going to be crazy.
Liga de Naciones, fusion. De estatales de la
see, de before partida. You do that, it's good that they create a tournament like this. So, si es un fiasco, they're going to see it and they're going to say, you know what? This idea that we had that we're going to fuse all the leagues, it's not going to work.
So,
pero mira, ¿qué pierdes, mi chavo? What do you lose? Nothing. You have a tournament. If it doesn't work out, then it didn't. And then, vámonos a la siguiente, let's go back to the drawing,
it's not what we're losing, super, is you don't understand the process for a player the way it should be treated, the way it should go. If there's going to be a lot of players that are going to give, they're going to be given the opportunity to play this tournament, there's going to be a lot of players that are going to be just thrown out there just because you don't want to use your main players, or you want to give them 5 minutes because you have a rotation. Your main focus still is your tournament. It's Liga MX. Maybe for MLS players or MLS teams, it's not, because they play around your tournament, a year-long tournament for MLS, and they have a lot of gaps where they play 3 games, 4 games in the same week. They play a bunch of players with the rotations. They have a big squad. Pero qué pasa cuando juegas este torneo y a San Luis se le lesiona su goleador, o a Mazatlán se le lesiona su jugador importante, su portero? ¿Qué pasa si a Juárez se le lesiona a Rondán, que apenas acaba de llegar y empezó a meter goles y empezaron a ganar partidos con eso? ¿Qué pasa si a Atlas se le vuelve a lesionar Furcho, se le lesiona?
Esas lesiones pueden suceder en la Liga MX igual.
Pero prefiero que me pasen jugando un torneo de liga importante, siendo algo importante para mi equipo, que me puede dar puntos para poder competir por un campeonato que tengo años que no lo consigo, hasta irme a un torneo pitero, un torneo
de Juárez llano. Igual y puede tener la oportunidad de llegar a una Conca Champions.
Sí, la puede llegar a tener si compite bien en su liga. Esa es una oportunidad que se le da a los.
Pero ese, creo que es algo más difícil. Anyway, I don't think we're gonna end up getting to a conclusion. We're just gonna agree to disagree. So that's just what it is. The new format, and we'll see if it's successful or not. Maybe lo continúan haciendo, y si no, if it's not successful, lo pueden tachar, como dice Super. Anyway, everybody, that's all the time that we have. Hopefully you guys enjoy the future Leagues Cup, and don't forget to tune in to El Mexican Soccer Podcast next Thursday. All right, everybody, see you guys next week.